anything from missing people, missing children, assisting fire with their calls for service.
They're in the sky, flying above, around, and through police situations.
We use it to locate and apprehend suspects. I mean, you name it, as long as there's a public safety interest, we can use those drones.
Departments across the valley have drones. Chandler, Scottsdale, even the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office and DPS. Earlier this year, Mesa Police flying a drone inside a house with a barricaded stabbing suspect. Cops use them to scan, photograph, and reconstruct accidents. And they're serving as an eye in the sky, smaller and cheaper than a police chopper. A drug case in Tempe with cops serving a warrant on an apartment in a high-rise near Mill Avenue led to a drone in the air to watch the building from the outside.
The people inside that were the focus of that warrant decided that it would be in their best interest to try and ditch the evidence.
The drone caught someone pop out of the apartment and throw a bag off the ledge. It landed on the roof of another building down below.
There was no way that someone on the street could have caught that.
In Chandler, cops put up the drone to find two suspects hiding in a cotton field. They could hide from officers on the ground, but not from the infrared camera. And the Chandler SWAT team had a suspect inside a house. Instead of going in blind, they sent the drone up the stairs to make sure it was clear. But what do the cops have to do to launch their drones? Tempe police say they ask for a warrant, but there's no law that says they or anyone else have to.
We have special language written into the warrant that the judge authorizes the use of the drone.
Right now, a warrant is not required for police to use a drone, just like there's no warrant requirement for a helicopter.
A warrant requirement would be a big way to start in the sense that you have to actually go to a judge and get a warrant that a drone is needed for an investigation.
Matthew Gariglio with the Electronic Freedom Foundation says drones are different because of what they could do.
A big fear we have is that somebody will fly a drone over a protest equipped with, you know, a really advanced facial recognition software and in an instant have a list of everybody who is in that crowd.
Which is technically possible, but right now it's not exactly easy and it costs a lot. Still, privacy advocates don't want police having these tools unrestricted.
Regardless of the reasons police departments say they need the technology, they're going to deploy it every chance they can get.
And they are. These drones are cheap and they're easy to fly. We found departments across the valley using drones hundreds of times per year, keeping an eye in the sky above the valley. William Pitts, 12 News.